We're now joined by Dr. Andra Gardner, who is a professor of environmental science at Rowan University. Good to see you, doctor.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
As succinctly and clearly as possible, make the connection between climate change and all the incredibly horrific, devastating floods and hurricanes we've been having.
Right. Well, we know that climate change is here now. It's no longer a problem of the future. It's something that is here now, and it is going to impact all of us. And we are seeing that very clearly in a lot of the recent events that we've been experiencing. A good example is Hurricane Ida that came through here recently. We saw record-setting rainfall in northern New Jersey and Central Park in New York City. And that's something that we do expect in a warmer climate. A warmer climate means we have an atmosphere that can hold more water. So it makes those types of really intense rainfall events, which of course correspond to flooding as well, much more likely and more intense when they do happen.
In terms of where we are right now, Dr. Garner, is it inevitable that this will continue, A, and B, if it's not, what can and should we do playing catch up right now specifically?
Right. So we know that right now we are already committed to some additional warming. We can think of it as we've already put the carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. And so we've kind of already paid for that warming. It's on order and it's going to happen. So we are going to see additional things like future sea level rise to some extent. And so it is very important that we start to prepare to deal with those challenges that we are inevitably going to face. But it's also really important that we remember that we do have some hand in our own future, and we definitely have some control over how bad those future impacts become. So it's equally important, if not more so, that we also work to reduce our emissions to try to limit future warming and avoid some of those worst case future scenarios.
So, doctor, I don't want to be a hypocrite. To be part of the solution. I can say I believe in climate change. I want to be supportive. But we also have a home at the Jersey Shore pretty close to the beach, like right there. So A, should we have built it after Sandy? B, should we be looking to sell it, knock it down? I mean, you tell me.
Yeah, I mean, that's a really big challenge for us. And, you know, certainly here in New Jersey and around the world, we have, you know, a lot of coastal infrastructure around the world. That's where a lot of our biggest population centers are. As you said, you know, we have lovely beach towns and coastal homes that we like there. And so it is a challenge that we need to be thinking about. I think we need to recognize that we will be dealing with additional kind of exacerbated impacts in some of those coastal communities, as far as, you know, sunny day flooding as sea levels get higher, and certainly flooding when we have storms come by as sea levels continue to rise and storms get potentially more intense. But it's also, you know, I don't think we necessarily need to resign ourselves to the fact that we're no longer going to have coastal communities, but we do need to be thinking very seriously about what ways we could potentially protect that infrastructure that was built during a very stable climate and now is undergoing rapid climate change.
In the limited time we have left, I want to ask you this, doctor. Specifically, policy changes that need to be made on the federal and the state level as it relates to climate change and everything you're describing, name a couple things we need to do.
Yeah, so this is, you know, a little bit outside of my area of expertise. I definitely focus more on
but from a scientific point of view.
Right.
Forget about policy and politics. What do we need to do?
Right. We do definitely need to be thinking about taking those large scale actions that will work to reduce our emissions. You know, we can all talk about taking small actions in our home, which are great and important, you know, using more efficient energy, light bulbs and solar panels, things like that. But we also need broad scale societal change. And that's only going to come about by, you know, adopting those policies at the state level, certainly where we work to get towards, you know, zero emissions future and really invest in green energy and renewable energy. But it's also going to need action at a national level and an international level, because this is a worldwide problem. And as the developed world, we all need to be working towards policies that will result in large cuts to our carbon emissions so that we can take those emissions down to a safe level, down to really zero in the future.
And not to mention how much concrete is where it is and what that causes when there is a flood or a hurricane. I'm not going to simplify this. Dr. Garner, I want to thank you so much for joining us, and also our friends down at Rowan University, one of our higher ed partners. Thank you, Dr. Garner. We appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you very much.
We'll continue the discussion, I promise, in another segment. I'm Steve Adubato. We thank you so much for watching, because last time I checked, climate change is pretty real. See you next time.
One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been a production of the Caucus Educational Corporation. Funding has been provided by the Healthcare Foundation of New Jersey, Johnson & Johnson, NJ Best, New Jersey's 529 College Savings Plan, the New Jersey Board of Public Utilities Clean Energy Program, Valley Bank, the New Jersey Economic Development Authority, Summit Health, the North Ward Center, and by the Adler Aphasia Center. Promotional support provided by Jaffe Communications and by the New Jersey Business and Industry Association.
What is your child's dream for the future? Doctor? Teacher? Architect? Whatever they aspire to be, a college education may realize those dreams. And NJ Best can help. It's the college savings plan specifically designed for New Jersey families. Start saving today with as little as $25, because now is the time to invest in their future. To learn about NJ Best 529 College Savings Plan, its investment objectives, risks, and costs, read the investor handbook available at njbest.com.